So you're going to want to go to acuvance.co.jp and click on the button in the center of this homepage to take you to the main website. Now, I recommend using the Japanese version of the website rather than the English, because the updates seem to be listed much faster there. If you go to this option on the top bar, and you look in the bottom left, you can see that it takes you to acuvance.co.jp/ESC/software. So let's click on that and get some downloads going. So now if you scroll down, you'll see that they now list it by list the downloads by device. So you can click on, in my case, I'm going to go for the Jarvis XX, which takes me through to all the options for that particular device. Now here's where we get a couple of files that we need. We'll start at the top. We need this update tool here. This is the actual software that you'll run on your PC when you actually want to do the updates. And then here below, you've got two different files. Now here's where you have a choice to make. The top option is if you're running Samwa or something that isn't Futaba radio gear. So you can just click the button and download that there. But in my case, I'm using a 7PXR. So I want this file here, which is version 2.0 for Futaba S-Bus. So now that we've got our files downloaded, we're going to go to our downloads folder and extract these two files. We'll start with the update tool. Just right click it, extract all, and then to your preferred folder. And then we might as well do the other one while we're there as well. So that's the actual update file itself. Same thing, right click it, extract all, and it'll get put in its own little folder. So here's the part that makes this update tricky and what most people get stuck with. So pay attention. So the way you do this is you need to go to Start, Settings, and then Update and Security. And then on this page, you can click on Recovery, and you see you get this Advanced Startup option. If you press that, the PC will restart and take you into a different menu that allows you to make various choices about how to fix your PC. So from this menu, we will need to press Troubleshoot, and then Advanced Options. And you can see here you've got Startup Settings, Change Windows Startup Behavior. Now if you press that, you can see here one of the things listed, or Disable Driver Signature Enforcement. Press Restart. So unfortunately my capture card doesn't pick up this next step, but you just need to press number 7 when this list appears on your screen. That would then restart with Digital Driver Signature Enforcement disabled. So now that we've restarted the PC, we just need to go back to the downloads folder into the files that we've extracted before. I'm going to start with the update tool itself. Right click it, run it as administrator. I'm not entirely sure that's required, but it's not going to hurt to do that. And what we're basically looking for as we do this installation is that we get a pop-up asking if a driver wants to, if we want to allow a driver to be installed. If we don't get that, the process hasn't worked and we have to move on to the alternative option. So we'll just carry on, install it. And then here's the driver installation wizard. And it tells us that it's been installed. Now, I don't think that worked, so I'm going to show you the other option as well. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go to the installation folder where we've just installed that tool, which in my case was C, Program Files x86, and the update tool. And then in there, you've got a keyence driver option. So what you can do is you can right click on this file here, the keyence setup information file, press install. And this is the most important part. If you don't see this during your installation process, it will not work. Like I say, in different versions of Windows, it may look slightly different, but basically Windows can't verify the publisher of this driver software. And it's asking if you want to install it anyway. You must click install this software, this driver software anyway. If you click anything else, or if you don't see this, your device will not work. So this is very, very important. So I'm going to install it anyway, and it's completed successfully. So now the device will work. So this is the point where you should just do a normal restart of your PC, just to put it back into regular mode. Okay, so now you can go ahead and open the update tool, and then go ahead and select ESC and connect the device. And you'll see you get a green indicator here that says that the device is connected. Now you can go ahead and connect the ESC. And you can see you get the second green light that tells you that the ESC is connected as well as the device. And you can now select the file to update with. go ahead and select the update button and then choose your downloads folder. And you can see this Jarvis XX version F2.0 that we downloaded and extracted before. And just select that file and watch it update. And that's it, we're done. So one of the common problems that people have when they do this is they leave too many devices connected to the ESC, which draws too much power from the USB port. So you need to make sure that you disconnect any fans that you've got connected to the ESC. Probably best to just disconnect it from the receiver as well, using the wire in the back of the ESC. Generally, that will sort things out. I have known people that have needed to just connect a LiPo to the ESC as well, but that shouldn't actually be required. So I hope you found that helpful. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, please hit that subscribe button and I'll see you in the next video.